Today I'm trying out Monarchy English Brown Ale from Little Brown Jug. They say this is a limited edition, so I'm kind of happy I got to taste it while it existed. The tasting notes on the label claim malt flavors of toffee, chocolate, and dark fruits, with a toffee and toast aroma and medium body. So today I'm going to be looking at this kit that I got from Banggood a while ago. In this kit, we have a Lowland Node MCU ESP8266 board. And with one pin banding, I have to straighten that out a little bit. This is sort of an older version of ESP8266 board. There's nothing wrong with it, but it's sort of predates the D1 Mini and that generation of boards, which are much smaller, but also break out a lot fewer pins. So that's probably why they included this in the kit, because you can do a little bit more with it if you choose to. So we're gonna need that, obviously. There's two breadboards. Always handy to have breadboards. There's a bunch of breadboard jumper wires. Although I don't know if I'm going to use these particular ones just because they're very long and they're gonna get in the way. Oh, we'll see. There is a DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor. Comes with its own female jumper wires, which I don't think I'm going to need for what I'm going to do. But those are good for if you just want to go straight onto the pins there. But I think I'm just going to plug it straight into the breadboard. What do we got here is a USB cable that is almost 3/4 of a meter, there about 700 millimeter, something like that. That's going to come in handy. We have the display board. It doesn't have pins with it. I'm going to have to solder my own pins on. Ooh, and the peel. No, I'm not going to put the music on this time. I'm just going to do a quick peel. So that can go on there. Now, these ones I've already pulled out just to see what they are, and I've soldered the pins on them. That is a GY30, which is a light intensity sensor. Not sure what that has to do with weather, other than tell, I guess you could tell your, have your program decide if it's day or night. Let's throw that guy onto the breadboard. And the last one, which also came with header pins that I soldered on earlier, just cause, is a BMP180 barometric pressure sensor. So there we go. I'm gonna go find me some pins to solder onto that guy. I'm sure most of you have seen this trick before, but when you're soldering header pins onto these modules, it's not a bad idea just to plug it into a breadboard so that everything stays nice and straight. And I'll just put away some of this extraneous crud and get this wired up onto the breadboard so that we can play with it. Also, I'm gonna have to come up with some software. That will take a little bit longer, but not for you, because it will just be the blink of an edit. Oh yeah, right, I gotta straighten that pin it, don't I? That often happens in shipping. It's not the end of the world. Just gotta be aware of it so you don't jam and damage anything. All right, I'll wire that up and come back when I've got some code for you. So here's the demonstration circuit that I've come up with. First of all, these Node MCU boards, and a lot of the larger boards, don't fit on one breadboard. Fortunately, they did include two in the kit, so I was able to bridge across them like this. That gives me access to all the pins. The other thing that I didn't use from the kit is I didn't use their wires just because they're really long. So I used some jumper wires from my own supply just to make it a little bit neater for this. Other than that, it's everything from the kit. So we have the display over here connected to I2C, that's SDA and SCL pins. Then we have the BMP180 barometric pressure sensor, also connected to SDA and SCL. Next to it, we have the GY30 light sensor, also connected to SDA and SCL. So each one of those three has a different address. That's how come they can all be connected in parallel to the same control pins. And then way back here, we have the DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor. That one talks over its own protocol and it just gets power ground and one pin, that being that one there, and I've got it connected. I've just picked arbitrarily, it's physically D4 here, but you see later in software, the physical pins and the Arduino labeling of the pins is different, which can cause some confusion when you're working with these boards, so just watch out for it and be aware of it. And that's basically it, and then power to everything. All these modules will run on 3.3 volts. Some of them require it. I think that display board, if it doesn't get 3.3 volts, there's some software trickery you can use to make it generated internally. But the ESP8266 requires 3.3 volts maximum. So the 5 volts coming in from the USB goes through this regulator here to generate 3.3 volts that powers the rest of the circuit. But that was the easy part. The hard part, at least for me, was coming up with software, because Banggood didn't supply any, and I couldn't find any written for this specific kit. So I pulled together some demos, and which are basically the demo sketches for each of these modules, and I put something together here. So there you can see through the shutter scroll that it is displaying all the parameters, and I'm just refreshing the screen every 5 seconds in software. So right now it's showing temperature and humidity off the DHT11. It's not quite that humid in my basement right now, but it is fairly humid. My dehumidifier says it's about 51 right now, and I've had to shut it off while I'm recording the video because it's noisy. The barometric pressure and what is coming off the BMP80, and the light level is coming off that GY30. So if I hold my hand over the light sensor and wait for it to refresh, you see it gets much darker. And if I just mechanically squeeze the pressure sensor, you see it changed. And then when I lift off, it should go back to where it was, more or less. I suppose I could lean in there and warm up the temperature sensor, but you get the idea. That is about the temperature that it is on my workbench. So that's one of the pieces of software. The other one doesn't use the screen and uses the Wi-Fi capabilities of the ESP8266. And I will probably demonstrate that best at the computer. So to load these sketches onto this Node MCU board, I just had to choose the correct board, and I found a generic ESP8266 module worked just fine on this. So I'm going to upload the second sketch that I came up with, the Wi-Fi one. I'm going to make both of these available for download. They're not stunning examples of programming skill, because I'm not a stunning example of a programmer, but they will be both available. It's not going to look quite the same. I'm going to clean it up afterwards. But once it's uploaded, we'll just go over here to the serial window, and it'll show us that it's connected to my experimental workshop Wi-Fi, and it has started. So we'll click on that. And there it is, your basic weather station, showing that it's 23 degrees, 56% humidity. There's the pressure, there's the light. And when I cover up the light sensor and refresh the page, it should show as darker. There it is. Refresh the page. That's the basics of it. Now the boring part that I'll try and make interesting, going through the hacky code that I put together. So here's the one that uses the display on the board. It's just standard Arduino code that, as I said, I stripped most of this out of the library demos for the various libraries that power the different modules. So SPI and wire and Adafruit graphics and that Adafruit SD1306 for the display, the DHT11, BMP. Yeah, that's all just straightforward includes. And if you're going to use this, just make sure you've got those libraries installed on your system using the usual methods. And then defines, and again, these are all stripped straight out of the demo sketches that come with the libraries. I've just separated them all out for easy finding. Setup, define stuff, blah, 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 begin the different libraries, and then the loop. Simply enough, we read the sensors, read everything out of them that we need, and then we print them on the little TFT module. Set the cursor to different lines and positions, print out the information, carry on to the next one. Bang, bang, bang. Wait for 5 seconds, then refresh the screen and carry on. It's as simple as that. And here's the almost identical stuff for the Wi-Fi version. Basically, I just added in Wi-Fi stuff and stripped out the display stuff, because I figured if you're going to be running this thing on Wi-Fi, you're probably not going to want the local display on it. You could glue them together if you want. I'm not stopping you. The various library includes, again, just got to make sure that they're all installed. And the include for the web server stuff, just the standard ESP8266 Wi-Fi library. I forgot to mention this earlier. So even though the DHT11 is connected to physical pin 4 on the board, logically in Arduino software, it refers to it as digital pin 2. So we just define that there, and the other library hit exactly the same thing. And then setting up the web server, of course, put your own SSID and your own password in there. I'm not about to show you mine. Create the web server instance. And then all this is the same. That's for the various different sensors. And here is more web server stuff. Just starting up the serial monitor so that you can find out what you're connected to and what the IP address is, because that's important. You could also, in the library example, you can set it up with a static IP address, but you just need to know what's available on your network if you're going to do that. And then the loop is the same until we get back down to the web server stuff, where it creates the basics of a web page. And there might actually be some extra crap in there that I forgot to pull out, but it's not strictly necessary. There is some, the demo that I pulled this out of had push buttons and window decorations and stuff like that, which I don't need for what I'm doing. If you're wanting a fancy web page, feel free. But anyway, it just prints out the name, the sort of labels, and the variables. Super simple. Even a hack like me can understand it. So this, I think, would be not a bad kit for somebody starting to get into the hardware side of microcontrollers and Arduino. If you're coming from the software side, since it doesn't come with any of its own software and you've got to come up with it on your own, it's not a bad little assortment of parts just to have as parts if you want to expand your collection / accumulation of Arduino related things. You could build it up onto a perf board or a circuit board to make it more permanent if you wanted to, without the breadboards and the jumper wires and stuff. You could park, you know, that side of it in a ventilated box someplace and just Wi-Fi to it to get temperature and sensor information. Lots of things you could do with it. I think it's kind of neat. And for, what was it, $20-ish? Not a horrible value. I think I'm going to be absorbing these modules and everything else into my general inventory rather than keeping it together as a weather station kit. But for what it is, it's good for experimenting with environmental sensors. Here is this kit. I got it from Banggood. Oh, it's currently on sale. I'll have a link down below. And I used to have a Banggood discount code for this thing. If I can find it, if it's still valid, I'll put it down in the description. Regardless, I'll put a link to this down there anyway. There is a link down here to a manual which isn't very useful. It tells you how to connect it up using software that it doesn't provide to connect to several web-based platforms. I couldn't find this documentation, and again, neither could the person that I talked to at Banggood. Hope you found that interesting. Hope somebody finds my code useful, if not amusing or horrifying. Let me know what you think down in the comments section. Like I said, I will have a link to this kit and to the hacky code that I wrote down in the description. So if you want to take a look, feel free. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.